All you derps and derpettes, my name is Derpaparilli and welcome back to another Pokemon discussion video, guys. Today we're going to be discussing why Ash is better than Red. And we're not just talking about any sort of Red, we're talking about the game version of Red. At the end of Heart Gold, and why not even throw in Sun and Moon Red as well? Let's get it. Anyways, I know a lot of you guys are gonna be like, but Derpy, but Red is better than Ash because Ash took a lot of balls. And shut up. You're wrong, and I'm going to prove it on why you are wrong. But as I always say in my other videos, play that intro, boys. Rolling. We're back at it again. Let's go. So, let's start off with Red. Game version Red. We all know that Red was supposed to be trash. Man used Thunder Smash on Onyx. But anyways, let's be serious right now. Overall, Red as a character is probably more raw than Paul. I believe that Red would honestly body Paul, and that's a big thing. That's a big thing because it took Ash like the whole entire season of Diamond and Pearl just to beat Paul. But let's see, how should I say this without triggering anybody? The reason why I say Ash Ketchum is better than Red is simply this. Over the past few years, we have seen Ash grow up from being an immature little brat who has no idea what he's doing to somewhat of a real Pokemon master who's just been taking bodies. Literally, if you guys have been seeing Pokemon Journeys, this man has been taking cheeks. He has literally been slaying everybody in his path. But not only that, we're not gonna go ahead of ourselves. We're not gonna go ahead of ourselves. Let's talk about the one and only moment where he was in Diamond and Pearl. In Diamond and Pearl, I believe if Ash was to fight game version Red, it would honestly come down to Ash still possibly losing, mainly because Ash just didn't have that sort of like real sort of strategies just yet. Like, it took him a while to finally realize, hey yo, I need a lot of like Pokemon to just do things, and I need to start thinking off of my brain. I need to just, ooh, wah, rah. He said, boom, bam, bada bop, boom, pow. But the way his team was already set up, if he was to go against game version Red, it might honestly go to just game version Red, simply because his team wouldn't be ready to face that sort of like powerhouse. Don't get me wrong. That man had an Infernape. His Infernape is so ready to beat the shit out of anybody. Man about to say, hey, yo, Pikachu, hey, yo, close combat. Stupid, quit playing with me. But let's get why Ash truly can beat Red, and those reasons are X and Y, X, Y, and Z, and Sun and Moon, and now Pokemon Journeys. And X, Y, and Z, Ash was finally given his Froakie. This man raised it, evolved it, nurtured it, loved it, cared for it. This man, Ash, literally made sure that he had a powerhouse on him. And that powerhouse team still somehow got bodied in the league. Anyways, the reason why I say X, Y, and Z Ash could take on Red is simply because of his Ash Greninja. And not only that, but his main sort of strategy sort of just kept switching up as the battle kept playing on. We would see that Ash would just switch up any sort of momentum he would have to just counteracting anybody else before they even had a chance to try and body him. We can see this is very evident after he beats Viola, but we see that after he goes all the way up to the last gym, which is Wolfric, he starts losing his shit. He's like, man, I've been taking bodies. How come I'm losing so much? And we see that Ash is like, you know, giving up a little bit, but, you know, Serena more shipping had to push it through. And so now he's like, boom, bam, bada, bop, boom. But we can see that Ash's strategies have drastically changed from all the other past seasons of Pokemon
up until X, Y, and Z because this man said Pikachu use Iron Tail on the ground while he's using Dig. Bitch came back up and said, "Guh." Overall, Ash's strategies have just skyrocketed, and I don't understand how the developers really did that. Like, their brain said 1,000, and they just said, let's give Ash the most OPS Pokemon, and let's still make him lose. He had an Hawlucha, Noivern, Goodra, Pikachu, Greninja. Oh my gosh, we can't forget the boys. But overall, I believe that Game Version Red from Sun and Moon would have to have a tough time battling Ash, mainly because of his Ash Greninja. Not only that, but I was also talking to a few other PokeTubers last night. We had a discussion about this as well. And shout out to my boy TSS_Killer. My man's told us that Red's Pikachu actually has a light bulb, and it's also been confirmed that Ash's Pikachu only has static. Now, I know a lot of people are gonna say, Derpy, don't you know that light bulb is better than static? This is why Ash sucks balls and his Pikachu is trash because it always resets it every re- Shut up. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter because his Pikachu is still on the journey. Who's still in the anime and who's not? Who's still giving out bodies and who's not? Let's talk about this. On to the next one, which is going to be Sun and Moon. Ash finally came up. But not only that, he came up and showed everyone here he could do it without even fully evolving all of his Pokemon. And I think that was the best part too. That was the greatest part too. He had his Rowlet still put in work without even evolving it. Without even evolving. How do you do that? Only Ash can somehow create strategies for baby Pokemon to still put in enough work to take out the final evolution of another Pokemon. Only he is able to do that. But not only that, the greatest thing about Ash and Sun and Moon as well was that his strategies kept getting even better and better. Though, I'm sad to say that they put Hal in too late, and I feel like they could have bounced off of each other like Dawn and Ash did before. They could have bounced off each other and gave each other new ideas for strategies as well. But the way that they put Gladion in for Ash as well, it's sort of great in its way as well, because Ash started to say, you know what, I'm gonna beat you, Gladion, and you know, I'm gonna say that you suck major donkey balls, bruh. Anyways, but in Sun and Moon, Ash is just like skyrocketing through all the trials. Not only that, but his Pokemon also started to see a different side of him. Like, they saw something that they never seen with any other trainer before. And I believe Game Version Red, man does not talk. Man doesn't need to say any type of commands to his Pokemon. Now that's pretty raw in itself. But at the same time, The way he will win this is through love and care for his Pokemon as well. Because we all know that when Ash says, come on guys, you can do it, get up, that's normally when his Pokemon find the extra strength in order to win. Now, a lot of people are probably going to say, Derpy, this is stupid. How come you're not really explaining how Ash would be able to be better than Red? I'm literally telling you right now that his strategies will be the dominating factor of why he would beat Red. Because Red just, he's just a whole powerhouse. I don't know how this man just became a big old powerhouse. Like, this man needs to take 3 seats. Like, relax, bro. Ain't nobody tell you to go that hard. We remember him going that hard in Heart Gold. Man was bodying our team. We needed like 99 revives. Man wouldn't let us live. But honestly, Ash from X, Y, and Z to Sun and Moon, they transitioned him perfectly because his strategies were still the same. Now in Pokemon Journeys, he's still taking bodies. He's making people get L's. So overall, I believe that Ash can just honestly take cheeks. He's just gonna take Red and say, hey yo, you wanna see me beat you up? You wanna see me do it again? He's gonna easily, not easily I should say, but he will give Red the hardest challenge ever. It's not gonna be easy for Ash, but honestly, I can say without a doubt that Ash would take Red's life. Not like actually, but you guys know what I mean by take his life by, you know, beating him up and yeah, you guys know what I mean. But anyways, if you guys disagree, let me know down in the comment section below. Or if you want to make a rebuttal video, hey yo, let me know, cuz I'll listen, I'll watch it, let me know. But as always, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you guys did, slash that like button. And if you're new here, be sure to tune in for more Pokemon content and new cartoon content such as this. And as always, I hope you guys had a lovely day, and I'll be sure to catch all you cool derps and derpettes in the next video, guys. Peace!